we present the news quiz with your host, Sandi Toksvig.
Welcome to the news quiz. We start with a cutting from the Litchfield Mercury, read by Neil Sleet.
A driver pulled over doing 94 miles per hour on the M6 told officers he was late for his speed awareness course.
And our thanks to Simon Turner for sending that in. Now let's meet the teams. Will you welcome first, on my right, Jeremy Hardy and journalist Samira Ahmed. And opposite them on my left, Susan Calman and Phill Jupitus. Susan, who should beware Germans not bearing gifts?
This is a story about Greece. If you've been following the news, you'll know there's a financial issue with Greece. I was watching the news the other day and the commentator said, Greece are about to run out of money. And it was quite offhand. It was like, you know, your pal Brenda, who's overspent on her credit card. Oh, Greece are about to run out. Oh, never mind, eh? They're going to run out of money at the end of the month because the rescue package from Europe runs out at that point. And there's been a lot of to-ing and fro-ing just now. It's quite a fluid situation, I think they would say. So, the Greek Prime Minister, who was elected fairly recently on an anti-austerity platform, they want to spend their way out of austerity in simplistic terms. And they went to the European Commission, to President Juncker, and said, Juncker, how do you pronounce that?
Go with it. I like everything you're saying. The way you say anti-austerity, it makes it sound like a relative who gives you really mean birthday presents.
So, President Juncker, they sent a letter saying, basically, look, we know we're in a bit of bother. Can we have another 6 months? And then we'll have a chat. And President Juncker said...
Do you think the clue was they sent a letter with no stamp on it saying to be paid by a recipient?
And President Juncker said, that sounds a really good idea, actually. Aye. And everyone went, oh, that sounds really brilliant, doesn't it? And everyone was like, oh, maybe there's going to be a solution to this. Aye, that's good. And then, da-da-da! Who arrived? Angela Merkel. And Berlin said, no, you're no having that. That's exactly what she said. No, you're no having that. And Greece is like, but we need to do it. And Juncker went, oh, no. Mum's spoken.
Well, it's better than listening to Robert Peston having you do this for us. Because, of course, the real fear that is that Greece could leave the Eurozone. And, I mean, if that happens, what?
Well, what I would say is that Europe is a very fluid thing just now. I don't know if you read this in newspapers, that Australia will be in a Eurovision Song Contest special. Now, no, listen, I think there is a line, and I think that line has just been crossed.
Yes,
never mind
it's
Greece.
Called the equator.
I wouldn't mind if it was Kylie or Danny doing it, but it's not, it's just going to be someone from Australia. And I think that's ruining what Europe always has been to me, certainly, Phil.
Absolutely.
I don't know about to you.
Yeah, no, that is ruining the spirit of a marvellous annual cultural event.
I think that Greece should go back to the drachma. I've got so much old holiday money lying about the house, I would instantly become one of the wealthiest citizens of Greece.
Well, if they did, then they can just print as many drachma as they want and start from scratch. Because money is all... It's not a real thing, is it? It doesn't have any intrinsic value. And banks create money all the time just by giving loans on the basis they haven't got gold in there. Go down your local TSB and say, would you mind opening the vaults? They haven't got anything in there. Money is all made up. So all Greece needs to do is make some drachmas out of... They don't even have to print them. They could just make them out of bits of aubergine if they wanted to. So I could just say Moussaka is the currency.
How do you say this? How do you say this, darling? Is it Syriza?
Syriza?
Syriza.
It's lovely. It's made with mint yogurt. A little bit of ground lamb, mainly aubergines, let's be honest.
Greece's request for a six-month extension on the Eurozone bailout has been rejected by Germany. Greece is currently ruled by Syriza, who were elected last month after vowing to end austerity. Syriza is a coalition of left-wing and radical parties, just like our government, but left-wing and radical and elected. The European Commission delivered an uncompromising message to Greece that it would have to stick to an austerity course, and to rub it in, we'll be delivering the cash to Athens in a giant wooden horse. 2 points to Susan. Samira, who has telegraphed both their disappointment and their notice?
This is Peter Oborne, who's the veteran, very principled
journalist at the Telegraph, I think about 20 years, who's resigned from the paper over a couple of things. One of them is that the paper failed to cover the HSBC Swiss banking tax evasion scandal because it was a major advertiser. But more importantly, they were making fundamental errors in kind of basic facts that Telegraph readers would know, like they confused the Earl of Wessex, and they, you know, they just got his title wrong, and they called him kind of the Muggle Overlord of Narnia, and just things like that. You know, the other great thing Pedro Bond did, he did a documentary many years ago, you know, he was running the Conservative Party, and he looked at that famous photograph of the Bullingdon Club, you know, with Osborne and Cameron and Boris Johnson in it. And as a result, that photo has been withdrawn in that you can't publish it anywhere.
Is that right? It's yes. Just banned.
Gilman and Soane, the publisher, said for commercial reasons it was unavailable anymore and you're not allowed to reproduce it and you're not allowed to see it. And it was quite interesting that he went after it. But the most fascinating aspect of this whole story of his resignation is he said, you know, they've been sacking journalists, they've been sacking subs. And then the Telegraph said, we utterly refute his claims, which is the incorrect use of the word refute.
Exactly. They meant reject, didn't they? Oh, it's unforgivable. Unforgivable.
But some more stories have been coming out from ex-Telegraph journalists or Telegraph journalists just now. And I think one of them was they came under pressure to raise the rating of Despicable Me 2 from a 2-star to a 3-star.
And coincidentally, Despicable Me is also the autobiographical title of HSBC's tax advisor.
At this stage in the game, the Daily Telegraph is ostensibly an Argos catalogue with a crossword at the back.
On the subject of tax avoidance,
yes.
I've come up with a very clever tax avoidance scheme, which is that all my broadcast work is on radio. Because what I found out is that the people who do the same job for the BBC but on television, some of them are paying tens, if not hundreds of thousands of pounds in tax solely for the reason that the BBC pays them vastly more than we do just because they wear a bit of foundation.
Obviously, here on the BBC, we don't have advertising. We are free from any influence. But can I just say, I think everybody should start their day with Danish bacon. Just saying. Peter O'Bourne, chief political commentator for the Daily Telegraph, has resigned, claiming that the paper was suppressing negative stories about HSBC, who are a major source of their advertising revenue. O'Bourne claimed a former Telegraph executive told him HSBC was the advertiser you literally cannot afford to offend, which isn't quite as snappy as the bank that likes to say yes. The Telegraph, or to give it its official title, HSBC News, denied they were influenced by advertising, saying we utterly refute any allegation to the contrary, before posing the question, are you paying too much for your car insurance? O'Bourne said newspapers had a constitutional duty to tell readers the truth, sending a wave of confusion around the offices of the Daily Mail. 2 points to Samira. Phil, why does claiming benefits from 18 to 21 mean working 9 to 5?
Yeah, the Prime Minister this week, Mr. Cameroon, a big African sponsorship deal, can't go into it now. announced that he thought it'd be a good idea that teenagers basically do 30 hours of community service for a week for their benefits. What I quite like about the current administration is they've turned life on this delightful little island out on the western edge of Europe into a Dickensian nightmare of incredible scope.
The Prime Minister's a big fan of Morrissey, and I was doing a feature for the BBC about this whole issue of pop stars and living on benefit. And Morrissey, of course, spent years on benefit, finding his voice before becoming a star. And yet at the same time, it's hard to imagine any politician would say, well, we should just let them all hang around at home in case one of them becomes Morrissey.
Well, one of the strange things he said was, he said there were two reasons he wanted this to happen. First of all, young people would get up early and discover what it was like to get up early and do a job. Well, make them breakfast TV presenters. Just do that. Put them on the telly, then they're getting up early. Secondly, he said something extraordinary like, everyone in the country will be able to then find their God-given talents, or no one's God-given talents will go to waste with this. What if your God-given talent is sitting eating pot noodle? What if that is, because I was great at that. I was amazing at eating pot noodles. I used to combine the flavours. I used to create what I think is culinary delicacies. I used to play online gaming. I made a lot of friends in Belgium.
I've only ever signed on once. I've been out of work many times. I only signed on once years ago. I was about 23. And I didn't like it. So I went along to the local old people's home and asked if I could volunteer because I felt I wanted to do something for the money. So they said, well, could you transport people backwards and forwards to the...
What, in time?
I am the doctor. So I borrowed my mother's car, and it was to take them to a daycare centre. And the very first person that I took, I thought it was safer to put them in the back of the car. I treated them rather like a child. I put them in the back of the car.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.